My name is Seki Munoz Jr. and I'm a state representative for District 36. And I'm really a couple of months into my first term as a legislator representing District 36, which before the redistricting process took place, that district encompassed the city of Farr, the city of Hidalgo. A lot of the South McAllen area would go into Mission, get a lot of the area south of Sherry Road all the way down to Granjeno, and then getting the Mission area to Palmview, Benitas. In the new district, of course, which we all know that it's still up in the air because of the litigation and because of the information gathering that the Department of Justice is continuing to do, that district gets me out of the city of Farr. I still have Hidalgo. I still have a portion of McAllen and Mission. Now I gain Alton, but then I go from 107 all the way to the county line, which is not only representing Palmview, Benitas area, and a lot of the rural area north, but now I'm also going to get the city of La Jolla and the city of Sullivan. So, like I said, and I know some of the other representatives touched on, that is still kind of waiting to be decided upon just because of the litigation and because of a lot of the information that's being gathered in terms of whether or not they're going to pre-clear the map as it stands. But I do want to just touch on a couple of the basic things that were already mentioned. In terms of the difficulty of the session, we not only found it a challenge for most of us, but we do know that a lot of the ideology and politics played into a lot of decision making instead of really being there to make a decision to do the right thing. And that is for the best interest, not only of our school children, but making healthcare accessible to a lot of individuals that need it, but also to continue to make opportunities and afford those opportunities to many students, to many individuals to get their higher education, which we know is going to lead to higher paying jobs, which is going to improve the quality of life, not only for the Rio Grande Valley, but also for the whole state of Texas. Also, just want to touch on a couple of things that I was very grateful to be a part of. We were able to restore $630,000 for South Texas College, which was that was going to restore the funding that was needed for the Bachelor of Applied Technology programs. In fact, at the end of July, we were already given approval for the third Bachelor of Applied Technology program, which is going to be in medical and health services management, which we know is going to also increase the earning potential. Earning potential for that field is anywhere from about $25 to $28 an hour, which I know is very important because not only does it allow for individuals to gain more money, to have better wages, but it's also going to improve the economy here so that they can become part of the system. Also, another bill that was very important to me was a bill that I sponsored in the House for Senator Hinojosa, which was Senate Bill 975, which is going to allow for partnerships to be created for dropout recovery programs between community colleges and local school districts, which is not only a situation or a challenge that we face here in the Rio Grande Valley, but it's also something that we see statewide as well. A lot of times we have so many students that are within 3 credit hours or 1 exam from getting their high school diploma or getting their GED, and that's very important because with Senate Bill 975, it's not only going to allow for those partnerships to be created here in the Rio Grande Valley, but beginning in 2013, that bill is going to be allowed to go statewide, which is going to allow for the same opportunity for other colleges to create those same partnerships around the state. So not only would it allow a lot of the students to get their high school diploma, but we hope that it will also allow and put these students on the path to get their higher education, whether that's an associate's, a bachelor's degree, or any type of degree that we know is going to improve the way that they live. It's going to improve the quality of life for their families. We're also able to be a part of House Bill 3746, which generated more funding for law enforcement programs, which investigate sexual predators who use the internet to prey on young people and children. Also Senate Bill 773, which provided the extension of the telecommunications discount, which allows for nonprofit hospitals, public schools, colleges, public libraries throughout the state to afford and provide high-speed internet service to their students, the medical professionals, a lot of patients and patrons. And without Senate Bill 773, that discount would have expired at the end of this August. And also, I was very grateful to be a part of House Bill 710, which it will improve the delivery of food assistance programs to working families while reducing waste and fraud. Speaking of border security, we know that this session, the funding for border security was increased. That money, of course, is going to have a great impact on our area, especially here on the border, which allows DPS, a lot of the local agencies, to continue to have the information sharing amongst our agencies, but it's also going to allow for new technology, for helicopters and more support to have more boots on the ground, which is going to make us not only feel safe as a community, but which will also help a lot of our local law enforcement agents as well. And I do want to just mention one of my bills that got vetoed, which was House Bill 1768, which was part of the Hidalgo County package in terms of legislation that they felt was needed to help the county in different parts of the area. House Bill 1768 allowed for a lot of the urbanizing counties, which are allowed to do it at this point in time, like Harris County and so forth, regulate a lot of the roadside vendors, which sometimes we see is an issue for a lot of the rural area here in the county. And it was just allowing for the enforcement of those roadside vendors, whether that be through a Justice of the Peace Court and so forth, just to have a little bit more of a uniform system in how they operate, but also to make sure that it's always a health and safety issue on a lot of the consumers as well. So we just want to have a uniform system in place to provide not only in their business, but to also make sure that they're abiding by the rules as well. With that, just want to thank you all for your time and, of course, let you all know that we're very grateful to have the opportunity to address you today. But please know that my door is open to you in any way in which way I can help, whether that's for yourself or your family or anybody that we can be of assistance of. We're here to help and we're here to do what we can to make sure that we're working not only for our district but also for our region and for the Rio Grande Valley. So thank you very much for your time. God bless you and may God continue to bless our great state of Texas.